Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. It's Trey, and I want to talk about NBC Annie, because NBC just announced that Annie is coming, and it's going to be December the 2nd, which, you know, December is my month year anyway, but, you know, neither here nor there. And they decided that they're going to do a race swap of Annie, and it's going to be introducing a new actress playing Annie, and Taraji P. Henson as Miss Hannigan. And as you know, Miss Hannigan and Annie in the original Broadway and state and a movie were both redheaded characters, and of course they made them black. But my issue is, you failed already at this before. Remember when Sony did Annie with I'm not going to say the little girl's name, because I know I heard her pronounce her name, and every time I try to pronounce her name, it sounds like I'm trying to insult the girl. So I'm not going to say the girl, but you know that she was nominated for an Oscar, the youngest person to ever be nominated for an Oscar, because of how much how well she did in God dang, I forgot the damn name of the movie. But she starred in the movie along with Jamie Foxx, and I'm just like, but it failed, you know, it failed, the movie failed. You had Cameron Diaz, you had Jamie Foxx, you had her in the movie, and the movie flopped like hell. And you're like, hey, wouldn't it be cool if we do Annie but live with black people again? No, oh God, no, Jesus Christ, don't do it to yourself. Don't do it to yourself. I don't know what makes you think Miss Wallace. That's her last name. That is her last name. That is definitely her last name, because no, it was an Academy Award, I believe. It was Academy Award. I believe it was Academy Award. But yeah, I am just not even about to do this with this with her name, because I feel like I'm going to screw it up. But Beast of the Southern Wild, 2012, yes, which nominated for an Academy Award, becoming the only young actress to ever be nominated, and as well as the first and to this day only. Oh boy, which is kind of crazy, because everybody was praising her role in the movie, and yet she didn't win no awards for it. That, y'all make it make sense to me. I'm just being honest. Let's call a thing a thing, girl. Let's call a thing a thing. I'm just saying. But that's just my opinion on it. But I just don't see what they were thinking with this movie. Because, I mean, not movie, but they're going to do a live-action stage play. So, of course, we're going to get a live-action stage play. We're getting here tomorrow. It's a Hard Not Life for us. And they might add that new song that they did in Annie 2014 one. The one they did. So, I don't know. I'm just trying to figure out, really, really, NBC? Is nobody not learning their damn lesson? And don't get me wrong, I understand it's supposed to be bringing Broadway to television, but Annie, not right now. Because, I mean, people's last memory of Annie was the 2014 one, and it flopped in theaters. So why would you think, hey, you know what would be really cool? If we decided to take two of the characters and make them black, but you didn't make you didn't make Mr. Warbucks. You didn't make him black, but you made Miss Hannigan black. Like, I don't know. And Harry Connick Jr. is supposed to be, that better be a bald cap that MF got on, because if he shaved off all that glorious hair just for a lame ass role, it's not a lame ass role, but just for a lame ass live production of Annie, I'ma slap him in his goddamn face. That is glorious hair that you just can't, you know what I'm saying? Like, you just can't get that kind of hair, especially toward when you're a little bit older. That hair is gorgeous. I hope it's a bald cap on, but it is what it is. I I know it's just kind of this random video of me talking about Annie. It's just kind of weird because I'm just like, what was you guys possibly thinking? Like, you know, my thing is, why do something that you already know was doomed to fail? You know what I'm saying? That's all I'm saying. It'll be different if they didn't do that, but they did do it again. And I'm just more confused on, hey, we failed in 2014, but it's 2021. Let's do it again. And especially after the disaster that was Rent live action wise, do you guys really want to do Annie right now? Because right now them live productions being a little bit hit or misses, to be honest. I mean, I'm just being honest with what I'm seeing right now. And I'm not really seeing much of anything that would make me convincingly like, oh yeah, this would be a good idea. Let's go for live action Annie. You know what I mean? Like I said, especially after the nonsense that happened with Rent right now, I just don't know. I'm sorry guys. I'm just not really feeling it. Oh, you know, I'm not trying to be mean or anything, but yeah, it's one of those things where you just kind of like, what was y'all possibly smoking? What crack is y'all possibly smoking? Because I just need to know. I just want to know, because you guys got to let me know, because I'm more confused and lost that this is the decision that you went with, because you really didn't have to go with this decision. You could have just easily said, hey, let's try to do, you know, classic Annie. You know, everybody is aware of Annie by her iconic red coat. I mean, her red sweater and her red hair. And it's not like you're going to take the black girls and give them red curly hair or whatever. So what would be the whole point? You know, at this point, the whole race swapping thing is getting like about goddamn old as hell. And the reason why I'm kind of talking about this too is because it failed. That's what I'm saying. It's just like they don't learn from their failures and their mistakes. Hey, let's try it again. No, let's not try it again. It was proven that people did not like it. People did not want to see this. And people can be like, oh, I enjoyed it. And that's okay. You can enjoy Black Annie. I'm not saying that you can't. But let's be honest. It flopped at the box office. It wasn't enough people to justify race swapping Annie. It really wasn't. You didn't need a modern twist on the character. And you didn't need to race swap the character in order for the character to work. You could have easily just did Annie. And that's it. You didn't need to do all that kind of stuff. I mean, hell, we even had one that was on the Wonderful World of ABC. That was pretty interesting. That was pretty good too, even though I ain't gonna lie, the classic Annie movie is by far the most superior version of Annie I've ever seen. Broadway stage productions, live, any other movie that came after it, cartoon series. No, I'm sorry. The original, 1960, I believe. I'm not really for sure. I just remember seeing it when I was growing up, and I remember it was fantastic. And I saw the Wonderful World of Disney one, and that was pretty cool too. But the new, the old original one with the big curly afro hair is by far the superior Annie in my opinion. And I'm just kind of disappointed that they would go back to the failure well and say, hey, let's do it all over again. And don't get me wrong, I like my girl Taraji P. Henson, and I think Harry Connick Jr. can definitely sing his ass off. Holy crap, that man can sing. But I don't know if this is the best thing. I understand they're doing it because they wanted to bring Broadway shows to television screens so people at home can see some of that stuff. But I don't know. I don't know. When you do that and you race swap the characters on purpose, especially because you're broadcasting towards television people who are watching it right there, like, wait, why is Annie and Miss Hattigan black? For what reason? Because there was a movie that you guys did that didn't work. And now you're going to do a live musical where people are like, wait, what? I mean, people might watch it. People might watch it. But I'm just saying, I just don't know if this was the best choice. I just feel like it's redundant to bring in the same nonsense you did in 2014 and hope for the best. But it is what it is. Am I going to watch it? I don't know. Because I just don't know. Because, I mean, it's coming out on December the 2nd. I don't know what day December the 2nd falls on. No, I'm not going to look it up. I'm too goddamn lazy for that shit. And I might be busy. So, you know how that goes. But, yeah, those are my thoughts. Tell me what you guys think about Black Annie. Are you guys excited about Black Annie? And are you guys going to watch it? And did you guys see the 2014 one? And did you see the Wonderful World of Disney one? And did you see the original one? And did you see the one on stage in Broadway? Let me know which one is your favorite one down in the comment section below. And I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.